B-Monster Laboratory here. So glad you could check out the video. I want to show you two things today. The first being the Arduino Nano screw terminal breakout board adapter for your Arduino Nano. And the second thing I'd like to show you is this 4 Patriots power cell USB solar charger. Pretty cool. If this works like I think it does, it's going to be awesome for small projects. First, I just wanted to show you where I got the adapter from. I bought it on eBay, and I wouldn't show you this if I didn't have a good experience. I don't know this seller. I've never spoke to them, but this is who I bought it off of. It ships out of Georgia, and the only thing, it took 2 or 3 days for them to ship, but when I received it, it was in perfect condition. Very happy with the seller, so I'm happy to share that information with you guys as well. And this is the actual adapter here, and as you can see, it already comes assembled, or at least it did for me. I ordered the one that was assembled. It's got the headers already soldered on, and then the screw ports already soldered on as well. You turn it over, you can see the soldering is very clean, very nice, very solid. Good job soldering. And you can see the labeling is good as well on the inside and on the outside where your pins are. And you also have the option to screw this down with screws that will fit through there. Screw it to wood or whatever you're working with, but for me, I'm going to put a couple spots of hot glue right here. I love using hot glue on these projects because it holds in a wide range of temperatures, and it also doesn't remove very easy, but when it does, it removes cleanly. Now, if you have a problem removing hot glue, you can always use some rubbing alcohol. Just put a little bit of rubbing alcohol on it. It will help break it down, and it will remove fairly easy. When you're attaching your board to your adapter, you go ahead and line up the pins on your adapter to the pins labeled on your microcontroller. Then you place it in the headers there, and you press firmly, and it should be flat, flush with the headers. And this will provide a firm attachment that is secure. Now, I've only played around with this adapter briefly, but you will see this in some permanent projects that I'm going to post here in the next week or two. I do anticipate this being very convenient because not only does it provide an excellent solderless connection, but it also allows me to remove the board in the future and make any changes I may want to do, or just change the code or whatever. So I like that. Now, the next item I want to take a look at is the 4 Patriots brand power cell. It's a pocket sized solar USB charger. I see here on Amazon it's currently $29.95 for just one. But I remember Christmas time, I checked the 4 Patriots website, and they do sell a bundle of 4, or at least they did at that time. They sold a bundle of 4 for $100, so that was a much better deal. I would look around before paying $30 for this. This power cell is used to charge mostly handheld devices such as cell phones, portable game systems like Nintendo Switch, cameras, iPods, iPads, so I'm thinking it might be a good option for a remote power supply for Arduino. The solar panel itself is just a little over 4 inches by 2.5 inches, which means it takes an absolutely long time to charge in the sun. The first dot you see there is the charge indicator, and the 4 dots after that are the level of charge that your unit is holding. On the top of it, you'll see a USB cover. Under the USB cover, there are some charging slots. You've got 2 slots that are USB, and in the middle slot, it's a smaller one, it's a micro USB. This power cell is equipped with a flashlight, and at full power, it is pretty bright. This power cell does operate on a lithium polymer battery, and it's not huge, it's 8,000 milliamp hour, but it's enough to charge your handheld devices. I've seen mixed reviews on this, but I took it to the beach and it performed just as I would expect. The user manual says not to use the solar panel as the primary charge, probably because it takes so long to charge, but given what it is and how small it is, it worked just as I expected it would. But for me, the real test will be to see how it serves as a portable power supply for Arduino projects.
Well, that's all I've got for today. If you have a favorite solar charged power cell that's portable like this, let me know in the comments below. I'm looking for a really good one. Also, if you've used this before, let me know what your thoughts are on that. As always, thank you very much for watching. My name's Brad, and I'll see you again
very soon. Thanks.